Hi friends, in this video we'll go over how you can use variables to set the max amount of selected items in Figma. As you can see in this example, I can select only up to 3 items, and once I have 3 items selected, all other options become disabled, and once I deselect one of the items, the options become enabled again. Lastly, I also have a counter here that tells me the number of items selected. So if you'd like to follow along, I'm going to link a blank worksheet that you can duplicate. And what you have in this worksheet are a couple of components, icon components. We have a button component that has a variant for solid and outline. And then I also have another variant for disabled. So a disabled primary variant and a disabled outline variant. Then I have a list item component with variants for the default one and the selected one. Lastly, I have this example of a model that has 5 list items and a header. I don't have any prototype interactions yet. I do have variables for colors, but again, nothing for prototyping. So to begin, I'm going to create a new collection and call it prototype. I'm going to create 2 variables here. The first one is going to be items selected, and we'll set it to 0. The second one is going to be a Boolean one. This one we'll call limit reached, and it will be set to false by default. Now I'm going to assign item selected variable to my counter. As you can see in my header, I have 2 text layers. And the reason for that is that if I had 1 text layer, I would not have been able to select the 0 to connect it to the item selected variable. So to assign the variable, I'm going to click this icon and set it to item selected. Now, if I change the default number of items to like 4, it's going to reflect in the model here. The next thing, we're going to assign this limit reached variable to this button instance. And this is very important because this Boolean variable will allow us to control other instances of list item in the model. I can be interacting with this item, but then this variable is going to help me modify the rest of the list items. All right, so now that I have created my prototyping variables, we can start adding prototype interactions. So the first one, I'm going to select this Add button, go to Prototype mode, and then click we want to create the if-else statement. The condition for the if statement is going to be, we want to check that the current number of items selected is less than 3. And if that's the case, we're going to change this variant to selected. We are also going to take our item selected variable, and we're going to increment it by 1. So it's going to be item selected plus 1. And if number of items selected is 3 or more, we're not going to do anything. So we'll just leave this blank. Let's see what we currently have. So I can add some items. And as you can see, I can add only 3 items. It doesn't let me add any more, and that makes sense because our condition was whether or not we have less than 3 items. But this current state is misleading because the remaining list items still look like you can add them. So we'll need to set them to disabled. So we're going to go back to our interaction. And what we'll do from here is after this if statement, we're going to create another one. And this one is going to check whether now the amount of items selected is equal to 3. Because we could have a situation where the number of items is 2, so 2 is less than 3. Then we change the variant to selected, and then we increment the number of items to 3. So now we've reached our limit, and we need to update our variants according to that. So this is why we have this second if-else statement. And the action here is going to be set variable. And this is where this very important limit reached Boolean variable comes into play. We're going to set it to true. Now let's go back to our model. And let's try this again. So now when the number of items is reached, the remaining list items go to disabled. And if I click them, nothing happens. But now, of course, when I click the remove, nothing happens either because we haven't yet created the logic for deselecting the items. So to create that logic, you're going to select the remove button and we're going to add interaction. So on click, we're going to change it back to default. Another action that we want to take is that we want to set the item selected minus 1. And once again, let's check what we have. So we selected a couple of items here. We can't select anymore. Then we remove one. we can see that the items selected is getting lower, but then these list items are still disabled. So what we would need to do here is there are multiple ways to check for this, but our overall goal is to re-enable the disabled variants. So what I'm going to do is for the condition, I'm going to check whether the item selected is now less than 3. And just make sure that you put this if statement after you decrease the item variable. And if that's the case, we're going to set our Boolean variable back to false. So now when we try a prototype again, we select 3 items, the other items become disabled. Then when we remove, the items become enabled again. And that's it for this example. Again, the most important thing here is this Boolean variable. This variable is what really allows us to control all of the list items and not just the one that we're working with. Please let me know if you have any questions. And as always, you can find the finished file inside my Figma community. But if you really want this to click, please give this a try inside the blank file first and only then duplicate the community files. Thank you for watching, and until next time, bye.